Welcome back. In our first Sunday Spotlight of the year, we're taking a look at how our lives might be different in the future. To tackle that topic, we invited internationally known futurist and marketing expert Faith Popcorn of Faith Popcorn's Brain Reserve to the program. She has guided companies like Coca-Cola to success with her insight into what will be trending in the years to come. Faith, thank you so much for being with us here on CT22. So we've seen over 2020 and 2021 a lot of work from home. You think that's something that'll get even bigger going into 22?
Very much so. I think people have had a taste of freedom and managing their own time. And, you know, when you let the prisoners out of the place, they don't want to come back. And we're seeing a lot of that, the great resignation, or, you know, just people managing their own time and working at their own pace. It's going to be very hard to get them back into the old way.
One thing I saw in your predictions for the new year was you talked about cocooning. What is that and how will it work going into 22?
Oh, cocooning, the big trend. Cocooning is a trend that we at Brain Reserve named and framed in 1981. And it's about, it made actually the Webster Dictionary, and it's about staying home. And we follow that trend and built that trend in a lot of our consulting work to say more and more people would want shelter from a tough outside world. And you see, you know, COVID socked that trend in. We positioned many, many companies based on that trend. So we're saying to all the, you know, home delivery company, everybody's going to want home delivery of food, home medicine, home education, home therapy, wanting to change the colors of their home through technology, home robot companions. Everything will be home. The home will become the hub of everything. And if the bosses want to see the workers, they will have to go to their homes.
I know we've heard a lot of stories about people, you know, get a new job and they've never actually met their coworkers in person. And I know that kind of goes through a lot of different facets of life. What do you see in the future with that? Will it be something where you may start a job and never actually go to the office?
I think a lot of younger people are having a problem with that because, you know, they get a lot of mentoring in person. But I think eventually, not only will you get a job and never go to the office, but a lot of jobs will be taken by people that don't need offices or light or food or vacations or breaks. And those are called robots.
So trends are your thing, Faith. And one of the things you mentioned to us that I thought was super interesting, and I think it's not COVID related, but you can tell us, is you see vegetarianism and pescatarianism as big trends in 2022. Why?
Yes, you know, we have a lot of, you know, food clients, big, you know, clients that are wondering, what do people want to be eating? And right now we're seeing a great sensitivity saying cows are so bad for the planet, torturing chickens, you know, to get on your plate is not great. And I think there's a real direction toward eating vegetables, or at least more vegetables, or pescatarians. I'm a fish-hating pescatarian, for example, which is having the protein in your diet, mainly fish. People are really concerned about, you know, not only the planet, but about hurting animals in the processing of them. And I think that they're really pulling back from that, especially kids.
So I know a lot of businesses turn to you to get info on these trends. So let's just take that one, vegetarianism, pescatarianism. Maybe there's a restaurant owner, someone in food service who's watching this show today. How should they maybe change what they do going into the new year to take into account what you're thinking is coming?
Yeah, they should change it quickly. If you notice that Burger King has an offering already about a vegetable burger, which is not bad. I think McDonald's is coming behind. Chipotle is a little bit slower, but if you can have an offering, at least if somebody is not eating meat, and meat means, you know, steaks, you know, beef or poultry or pork or ducks, then I think that you will be making a statement, even if you don't sell a lot of it. I think you will sell a lot of it, but even if you don't, it says you're a socially conscious company. And that's important.
One company that we've heard a lot about on the news is Elon Musk's various companies. And you talked about this Neuralink. I didn't even know what it was, Faith. I had to look it up. And it actually involves a chip implanted into the brain. And I got to tell you, in the article I found about it, an actual quote from Elon Musk is, "It's working well in monkeys, so we think we're going to try it in people." I'm not going to go first. What do you think about Neuralink?
I think he's tried it, is my opinion. This is what I think about Elon Musk. He's a genius, brilliant. He's a futurist, brilliant. And this Neuralink is a bit scary because he will be able to, you'll be able to say, this is a good part of Neuralink. Let's say you're a trauma, you know, victim, or you've been abused as a child. You're going to actually be able to erase those memories and reformat your psychological set. That could be okay. Or you'll think, what did I do last Wednesday? And you'll be able to rewind, you know, and actually see what you did, your memory, what you did last Wednesday. But I also think that he has some interest in seeing what you're thinking and maybe changing your mind literally. And that's a little bit on the edge.
Yeah, that certainly is. And that could change everything from a marketing perspective, right? If the chip allows a little bit of control. We only have about 30 seconds left. Does that change your marketing advice if that becomes a thing in the future?
I don't think we have to worry about it yet. But yes, you're going to have, like, you know, product placement in the brain, not on the TV. So absolutely. You know, but the nice part about all this is that, and Connecticut is so this, I love Connecticut. There's a nostalgia about Connecticut. There's a lovely time warp about Connecticut. And I think that a lot of people from New York have moved up there. And I think there's a loveliness, you know, about Connecticut. And the most popular movie right this second is It's a Wonderful Life. If you haven't seen it, see it. It's just like, you know, every time the bell rings, an angel gets their wings. So with all this technology on one side, there's a balance on the other, is that we're looking to, and back to cocooning, the warm and cozy.
All right, Faith Popcorn, we appreciate you being with us. And we also think Connecticut is a lovely place, no matter what Elon Musk tells us to think. Let's take a That's look. Right. If people want to learn more about Faith Popcorn and her brain reserve, here's the info. You can email her. It's faithpopcorn.com. Her email's on there as well. You can check it all out. Faith, thank you for being with us here on CT22. That is CT22 for this week. CBS Sunday Morning with Jane Pauley is next. Have a great rest of the weekend. We'll be back here next Sunday morning.